How gross is our office?
I'm furious.
I want a meeting.
How much pain can our sports guy take?
That pain is in the meat.
Josh, what are you doing? Are you going to do something soon or what?
How long can we survive in a hot car?
Did somebody just fart?
What?
What was that noise?
Why won't Ravens kicker Justin Tucker go into the ocean?
The fish use it as a tool.
There's that.
All that plus another edition of Can You Last 30 Seconds starting now.
Justin, Scott, and Spiegel?
The 98 Rock Morning Show?
Yep, I'm an idiot.
What is happening right now?
Pay me to talk!
What the f*** are they doing on my TV?
Justin, Scott, and Spiegel shouldn't be on TV.
Each summer we hear too many news stories about kids or pets being left in an unattended vehicle, so we decided to lock ourselves in a vehicle.
The inside of a car can get super hot super fast.
So we did a demonstration to show how fast it can happen, even at 9 in the morning.
It went from zero to gamey real quick.
I'm freaking out.
Are you already freaking out?
I'm so nervous.
81 degrees outside, inside of the car, it has already reached 88.
Oh, jeez. And how long have we been in here?
We have been in here for 3 minutes.
Okay.
Could we not have gotten a digital thermometer for in here? What is this thing?
We got this on Amazon Prime Day for a nickel.
Who's digital?
Whose grandmother did we steal this from? The iPad is overheating already.
What?
Yeah. The audio is down because the iPad has already overheated approximately 15 minutes into it. Damn. So here's the order. Babies, the elderly, pets, Apple products. That's what's got to get out of the car.
Could I do my order?
Yeah, go ahead.
Go right ahead.
Please.
Spiegel.
Pets.
Spiegel.
And me.
That's it.
That's it. Everything else, distant third.
No, wait a second. I want to update it.
Okay, what's yours?
Go ahead.
Okay. Spiegel.
I'm starting to feel it.
Current temperature is holding at about 95 degrees.
Outside?
In the car. Oh. It's 81 outside. It's 14 degrees hotter inside. We've only been in here for 15 minutes.
Prosecutors in Nantucket, Massachusetts.
Did somebody just fart?
What?
What was that noise? Is that what that was? Is that what that was?
Coming up next.
I heard that, but I didn't even...
What is that going to happen when this car starts?
What have I done?
Prosecutors in Nantucket, Massachusetts.
Did somebody just fart?
What?
What was that noise? Is that what that was? Is that what that was?
That was a total accident.
I heard that, but I didn't even...
Is that going to happen when this car starts?
What have I done?
Did you...
I heard it.
So sorry.
I heard it too, but it didn't register. I didn't know what it was.
Oh, I knew what it was.
So embarrassed. My body has slackened.
Why?
My body has slackened, and I would be like to be the first to apologize.
Where am I? I'm not there.
But I just ripped one off, and for that I apologize.
Let's
Josh?
Hope there's no odor. Do you have a history of odor?
Oh, I am such a filthy sweat pig.
Just farted.
I am so sorry. I'm the one
Taylor
person.
Grenda.
Hey.
Justin,
I'm sorry, Taylor. Taylor Grenda from WBAL TV 11 News. One of us just...
She just left. She walked away. We've been in here for an hour, and...
It's moist. It's musky. It's dank. It's creamy.
We got in here at 9 o'clock. It was about 80 degrees outside. It was what inside? 81?
81 outside. And what is the current temperature, Scott?
In the car, it is about 110
degrees. 110
degrees,
guys.
So that's what? Almost like 30 degrees in less than an hour. It's heated up in here. So
check your car before you get out of it.
Yeah.
Okay?
You hear all these people forget their kids or something. Mom's like little routine gets thrown off her. You know, she's got to go
And then next thing you know,
I feel like I forgot something.
Yeah.
Oh, wait a minute. Life is over. So, yeah, take care of your old people. Take care of your dogs and cats. Take care of your toddlers. We'll be back tomorrow for another. Oh, my God. We forgot Paul in the trunk. We got to go. Talk to Paul.
Air.
Oh, that feels so good.
Oh, that feels good.
Yeah. How's my ass? Justin, how's my ass?
Oh. Wow, look at the short coverage. Yeah. You'll notice that the crotchel stayed relatively dry. The outer regions are where it got dank. Me, thigh area, very moist. Scott, huge weather system coming in. El Dongo, blowing in.
What about this?
Check out that butt. How's that butt? Nothing butts. Hey, moisture?
Some things are better left unknown.
Like knowing how much bacteria is on our communal office coffee creamer.
I was completely unfazed by this discovery.
Oh. Spiegel went downstairs to get some coffee.
That's right. That's right. I remember this.
And it was not a good experience all the way up until starting with the coffee itself, you hated. But are you drinking it now?
I'm drinking it now because I'm trying to not have extra calories, and I need caffeine. So it tastes fine. It hasn't given me a stomach ache like the last time, and that's why we sent Hannah down to swab for bacteria.
Because you, the coffee gave you a stomach ache, and then you were wondering about the innards of the coffee machine, if it ever gets cleaned, and what kind of bacteria and mold is growing within the machine.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then you thought about, well, what about the creamer that everybody in the effing building touches
and
after
the
after they go morning poo-poos, and there's feces all over
it. That's right.
And then the sugar one's got the fecal on it, and there's fecal everywhere, and there's germs, and people are sniffling and sneezing and touching creamers and sugars. So we took it upon ourselves to swab the, not just the creamer, just the creamer container?
Just the creamer.
Okay.
I assume, I figured some things should just be.
And this is a powder creamer, right?
Yes. The non-dairy powdered creamer.
Okay. I'm so nervous.
You should be.
Oh, God, no.
I will say, it's.
Oh, no.
Let me see it.
It's.
Oh, no. I want a meeting. I want something as unacceptable.
It's not as bad as the beards, other than the fact that there's so many different types of bacteria on this one.
So there's a variety. I'm going to kind of... Oh, look at that chunk!
No,
that thing that's growing?
That's
portobello
mushroom.
I knew it!
I tried to identify them.
Fecal!
What are they?
That is pure turd. Now, Josh, you'll notice.
You know what they are? You don't know what they are.
I tried to figure it out online. I have some ideas.
Okay, go ahead.
The smallest dots, the white and yellow, are just regular bacteria. That's what a cough would look like.
Oh,
if you coughed into a petri dish.
They coughed in their head and then they thought.
That's what a cough looks like?
They must have, yes.
Okay, what else?
Oh, I'm gagging.
So that weird white poofy thing.
Yeah.
And that really strange, like cloudy white spot that looks like it's got veins running through it.
Yes.
That might be yeast.
Creamer has a yeast infection.
I want that kitchen scrubbed
that
from top to bottom today.
Has a yeast infection.
Gross.
The Keurig's got a UTI. I want to die right now.
Anything else?
What about the red puffy one?
Yes.
The brown in the middle.
That's mold. That's 100%
mold. Oh my God, there's mold. Oh, I'm furious. I want a meeting. I want something as unacceptable. Mold.
Look at it.
On
grab it. Hold it.
No.
Hold it.
Look at all the different types, too. It's not just one strain.
Disgusting.
There's small ones, big ones, green ones, white ones, brown ones. That is so much different.
Gross.
There is turd. Oh. There is pee-pee.
Don't
there
touch anything.
Yes.
Don't touch hazardous materials.
We need FEMA in here today.
God.
Take that machine and throw it in the trash. Take the creamer and throw it out.
Smell it. Somebody wants us to smell it.
I'm not smelling.
Justin, you're the smell tester.
Smell it. Give it to me.
He's got
it. Oh, it was so bad last time. And, it, and that was like one type of bacteria per Oh, no. And yes, I know people that are about to text in. If I do this, I'll die. Whatever. I welcome death these days. You should see my BGE bill. All right, hold on.
What about licking it? Would you like
not
that?
A oh, chance. God. No. I'll do a lot of dumb stuff for you guys. That ain't one. All right, hold on. I'm opening my this up.
God. I'll post some pictures soon as well.
Absolutely crazy.
Which side do you want me to smell?
Just smell the whole thing. That. Right in the middle. Get a... Oh my god. You need a trash can? Oh, it's heaving. Oh. Here.
Oh my god. He's throwing up.
He's vomiting.
Oh.
Is it? Oh my god. No! It's that bad?
It's so bad.
Oh my god, this place is disgusting! This place is disgusting!
It smells so unnatural.
Our creamer has a yeast infection!
Up next.
This is Justin Tucker of the Baltimore Ravens giving a massive shout out to Justin, Scott, and Spiegel, my favorite guys in the whole wide world with the sickest radio show on planet Earth and beyond.
The greatest NFL kicker of all time, Justin Tucker, was live with us at the Ravens training facility in Owings Mills.
And he talks about how he protects his legs.
And I wasn't there.
Justin Tucker, what is a day like when you come here? First of all, are you in the off season? Are you normally up this early?
I am now up this early in the off season
because of the child.
Yeah. Okay. And so he's up. He's up pretty early. He's up 6:37.
Yes.
Each day.
God,
before we had Easton, my wife and I, we'd get up at 7:30, 8:30.
And how old is he now?
Three.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Oh, I think we've all been there, guys. I think we've all been there, right?
I've heard somebody call them three-nagers these days. They're so independent.
How do you keep that part of your body safe? How do you strengthen it, make sure it's in tip-top shape? Like the whole year, you got. What do you do with your legs?
You can't get fat legs in the off season.
That's 100% right, Justin.
Thank you.
Yeah, you don't want to have like dumpy kicker legs at any point. So you got to stay on top of that kind of stuff.
But do you wear pillows around your legs to protect them?
Like a Lloyd's of London policy?
Yes.
Do you have your legs insured like a dancer?
Right? Of course he
does. You have to have leg insurance.
I don't.
Well, you are playing with fire,
Tuck. Look into that.
We got to get you leg insurance.
I like to live dangerously. What can I say?
But I have to assume, though, you're active on social media and some other people are. If they see you like at a trampoline park somewhere? Are you getting a call from the bosses get your ass off of that right now?
Well, that happened with Patrick Mahomes. He was like playing basketball, just getting some activity going, getting a little cardio, playing a little b-ball, and then
I blew out my ACL.
I mean, that's a spot-on impression.
You should hear Scott's. It's unbelievable.
Patrick Mahomes, how would he describe that?
His knees look like they're in a pretty bad situation. He probably jump a bike as far as I can throw a football, like 83 yards.
But yeah, he hurt himself.
Well, no, so I don't know anything about that. But like, I don't believe he hurt himself. But it was a story pretty quickly that
that he was doing
Andy Reid and the GM made sure to let him know, like, hey, let's keep the basketball to like a minimum.
Oh, wow.
We don't even want you
walking. Do that. I don't go into the ocean anymore.
The fish use it as a toilet.
There's that.
It's disgusting.
Yeah.
And people are walking out of the ocean these days with, like, deadly skin infections.
What are you afraid of in the ocean?
Sharks.
Are you serious?
Well, that's their house. Like,
right.
I'm not.
Are you really serious about?
If a shark came into my house.
Yeah.
Like, this is America. We have the Second Amendment.
Shout
right.
out.
Like, right?
You're taking a slug to the fin.
You're like,
meanwhile, you're going into its house.
You're getting dealt with.
I'm going to bite your head
meanwhile,
off.
Meanwhile, I feel like that's totally understandable if a shark wants to take a take a chomp at me
yeah.
because I'm in his house.
Of course, but I just...
Because I don't know the yeah. rules of,
are you also
of the ocean,
afraid?
Let alone international waters. Let's not even go there.
Oh, God,
that's
the
where
horrors
it gets crazy.
That are... That's no. when you got megalodons and giant squids,
you got
pirates.
Bermuda triangles. And,
I totally agree about the shark. That's we're going into there. But I just want to clarify that you're serious. Is that the reason you don't go into the ocean? Because you don't want to be bitten by a shark on your leg?
Pretty much. Like, I won't go into the ocean past my, like, knees.
Okay.
Every morning, four times a morning, we're blessed with the news and comments of our own Josh Spiegel.
Oh, you know, it's just what I do. Look at some stories from this week.
Time for my annual roundup of July 4th fireworks injuries when body parts declare their independence from bodies. In Fort Worth, Texas, a 19-year-old man holding fireworks when they exploded. Fireworks were not only going off up in the air, but horizontally.
Ooh, yeah. Ooh, that's yep. the direction you want them to
that's
go
not...
in.
Yeah, and this the people were also shooting fireworks at each other during this event.
I'm a big fan of that. I'm sorry.
I'm not anymore after last Wednesday. I am fully
it's
out.
Just in my blood watching my drunk Irish uncles have Roman candle fights.
Sadly, a firework crashed through a front window
oh,
of a
no.
home.
Oh, no.
Exploded and burned a one-year-old's leg.
Oh, no!
Here is a neighbor commenting on that in Fort Worth.
I was even afraid being out here, but I stayed in front of my son's car, you know, for secure.
For secure.
They find the best person.
Damn, I was
she forgot the end of the word.
I was even afraid being out here, but I stayed in front of my son's car, you know, for secure.
For secure. I was out front having some plantain chips. I like to dip it in a remoulade. And that's when I heard the explosion.
Up next.
All right, here we go.
Ready?
Stand up. Okay.
Set. Go.
No! Word got out that I have super sensitive nipples.
Perfect ammunition for our favorite game, Can You Last 30 Seconds?
See how long Justin can last while Scott plays with his nipples.
Oh, God.
30 seconds on the clock.
All right.
And here we go. All right.
Oh, God.
Oh, God.
Sorry, here we go. No, almost fell. All right. Here we go. All right. Here we go.
Ready?
Stand up. Okay.
Set. Go.
No!
Oh, wow. Never seen a face like that.
I can't.
You got, wow. I think that was 12 seconds.
I can't do it.
If my math was right, 12 seconds.
I can't do it. It's like electricity.
I'll tell you what, you lasted longer than I thought you would.
Ooh, no, that was me fighting. 2 seconds in, I wanted to bail.
12 seconds. 12?
I think it was 12 seconds.
Wow.
Yes.
All right, Hannah, you're up. Wait, we're just having fun. Oh, God. You have a soft touch.
Thank you.
You have a soft
Thank
touch.
Thank you for that.
Ooh, it's they're
oh,
still
that
going.
That was weird for me.
They're still going.
That was weird for me.
I need this erection to stop.
Paul Mittermeier told us he can block pain just by changing his mindset.
And we immediately put that statement to the test.
By intentionally inflicting pain on him.
It was an epic power display at the Home Run Derby in Cleveland last night. 312 total home runs Whoa. Were hit. Vlad Guerrero Jr. hit a record 29 in the first round.
Oh, my God.
He hit 40 in overtime and won 40-39 over Jock Peterson. Ultimately, though, he lost to Mets slugger Pete Alonso in the
Die!
Finals.
That pen is in the meat.
Josh, what are you doing? Are you going to do something soon or what?
I'm almost to the bone.
I'm looking.
I promise you.
At Spiegel the is pen. Stabbing Paul in the yeah, shoulder with a pen while Paul is reading sports.
All right, Scott's turn to stab Paul.
Can you really block out pain?
I don't know if I want Scott to do it. Scott's...
You're like a super soldier. They need to take your blood and study it. Okay, All now right. Scott's going to give it a crack.
I know.
Hey, Paul, talk to me about Ravens practice.
Training camp starts. July 27th, Veterans Report. July 29th is the big stadium event for the Baltimore Ravens.
Oh my God.
Where you can go down to the stadium. They have fireworks. They have.
Oh my God.
They have. All right, that hurts. That hurts.
Oh my God, Paul. How does it do that?
Are in showman.
Dude, seriously, cut your leg off sometime and you learn real fast how to block
out
pain.
That's what I was going to get to finally, is that this has to do with your leg, obviously.
We've been with this guy.
Can I try another? Can I try squeezing your shoulder like really hard?
Sure, come on.
Okay.
Now, are you like mentally blocking it out, or it just happens?
I think, you know, you just focus on doing something else. And you don't even think about what's happening to your shoulder or what's going on.
Josh
with that.
Is squeezing him as hard as he can.
Seriously, you just do that, and then you just don't think about it. And if you don't think about it, it doesn't hurt. It's like, think about in the summertime.
What?
Seriously.
What is happening?